Does your body get used to Viagra or Cialis? Is this possible even at young age? Reddit posts and internet forums will tell you otherwise. Truth or myth? That's the question, and a very important one. Erectile dysfunction is very common. Did you know that we are talking about 1 in 4 young men? Back in the days, that was unheard of. But why? I have a surprising explanation, and no, I'm not going to press the psycho button. Relax. Problem with this video, I'm addressing a very special group of patients, young men. Too bad, the YouTube algorithm almost never shows my content to young men. So if you are young at heart, watch with the wisdom of your years and forget the number on your passport. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, urologist and specialist in sexual health. 1 in 4 men under 40. I've seen this number in one publication. Don't quote me on this. That was one study. The number might be less alarming. But nevertheless, urologists around the world observe this trend. And that's a fact. Onset of ED happens earlier. So far, the only answer my profession has is this. It's psychological. If they want to be nice, they say it's venous leakage, but that's only polite wording for head case. And they prescribe Viagra to 20-year-olds. Well, it works in most and gets them out of the office fast. Time is money, and modern medicine is not designed for time-consuming consultations, because that's what it is. Erectile dysfunction in a young man is not the norm. So why is it happening anyway? I'll get to that in just a second, but first things first. So they get a prescription and start with Viagra or Cialis, and it works for some years, but then in their 30s, the drug fails them. First once, then twice, and then regularly. Has Viagra stopped working? I could give you the answer right away, but there is a risk you won't believe me. Therefore, why do you get used to some drugs while other medicines don't have that trait? It's the liver. Most of you have heard at least the name of that organ, but I'm not sure whether you know what it does. The liver is your number one detox organ. It's a toolbox full of intelligent solutions for eliminating alien substances. Take alcohol, for example. The liver does a great job in getting rid of it. If you drink more, the liver will work harder, and it will remember that 8 o'clock every night there is a drink coming in, and it will be prepared. This is the reason why alcoholics tolerate alcohol a whole lot better. Their livers are trained. The same principle applies to some medicines, but not all medicines. Codeine in cough medication is one example. Some laxatives follow the same route. The more you take, the more your body adjusts. Now you're probably asking yourself, what about Viagra? Which makes me ask, what about subscribing to UroChannel? If this video is about making something rise, why not start with your thumb? Hit like, subscribe, and if you're into staying ahead of the curve, hit the bell as well. Thanks for watching and for being the kind of guy who takes his health seriously. So here's the answer I promised you, and it applies to all age groups. So what about Viagra? Yes, it goes through the liver. Like many drugs, it's processed by a system called cytochrome P450, more specifically, an enzyme named CYP3A4. This is the liver's biochemical toolbox, the same system that breaks down many other medications. But here's the important part. Just because Viagra goes through the liver doesn't mean your liver gets used to it like it does with alcohol or some other drugs. There is no classic tolerance effect here. Your liver doesn't suddenly wake up one day and say, "Oh, it's him again, process faster." That's not how it works. So if Viagra stops working, it's not because of liver adaptation. Drug tolerance in PDE5 inhibitors is not possible, technically speaking. The drug didn't fail. The system did. Now it's getting interesting. How can the system fail? Sure, with age, systems change. That would be an easy explanation. But not in this case. Today, we're talking about men in their 20s. And here's the surprising part. Their system fails too. just in a different way. But where and how? It is complicated. Let me break it down the easy way. Erections need relaxation. Viagra needs a certain degree of relaxation for effect. Growing up in a digital world has become much more challenging than when things still were analog. I'll spare you the details, they're all over the media anyway. In principle, young brains are overhyped by excitement, entertainment, porn, gaming, you name it. Excitement is the opposite of relaxation. If your days are not structured, when you sleep at random or even in fragments, it changes your system. You switch on fight and flight mode permanently. We have a name for that in medicine. It is called the sympathetic nervous system. If you really turn it on, it increases the tone of your penile muscles. The muscle inside the cavernous bodies is contracted when you're not sexually aroused. Did you know that? It relaxes when you get an erection. The more it is contracted, the harder it is to bring about an erection. And Viagra? Sometimes even that isn't enough to overcome a hyperactive corpus cavernosum. Excessive pressure within the penis as a possible cause of ED has been known for a long time. Yet, in 9-to-5 urology, this concept has been disregarded. It's either vascular or psychological. And that's like talking about red wine and white wine while disregarding rosé and all the other varieties. But seriously, guys, muscular activity within the penis is measurable. This is how we know that many men with erectile problems have increased muscular activity within their penis. Who's responsible? The sympathetic nervous system. This one is a hard nut to crack. Sometimes when sympathetic tone really gets going, the pelvic floor muscles may tighten likewise, and grinding your teeth at night also belongs into this category. Viagra can override parts of the sympathetic surge, but if your body is locked in overdrive, no pill can make you relax. This is the turning point. Within a vicious circle, it goes like this. Increased sympathetic activity leads to erectile dysfunction. With time, overall tension may increase. Then Viagra fails to work. That causes panic and insecurity, which increases tension and sympathetic tone. So your body didn't get used to Viagra. It didn't stop working. It works, but not in a system that has lost responsiveness. Now you want a solution, right? Well, I don't think there is a one-size-fits-all solution, but bringing structure into your life is a good start for everybody. This means no light from screens immediately before bedtime. Go to bed at the same time every day, also on weekends. Opt for 8 hours of undisturbed sleep. No late-night caffeine, no energy drinks, and definitely no monster at 11 p.m. Young men with erectile dysfunction are a difficult group to treat. Several things coincide here. Starting with sleep regulation is an easy first step. Talking about ED to a partner, being disciplined, showing endurance despite backlashes and frustration, and accepting that there is no easy way out after all, that's the real challenge. When Viagra stops working, it is a frustrating experience. I have more videos with additional details on my channel. Sometimes you need to hear it several times with different words. Here they are. So follow me. I guide you through the swamp of online information.